Hello my dear students, this is Rukayan Alwala and in this video we are going to study about the different body movements which happen in human beings and also in animals. Now when we are moving, when we are walking or running or doing any work, we notice that our body moves, but when we are sitting still then also many parts of our body move without us knowing, that is blinking our eyes. We do not notice when we blink our eyes, but it is also a movement happening in our body. Also when we are turning our head, we are moving our head front and back. So that is all the movements happening when we are sitting and doing no work. Human body and its movements. The places where two bones and or meet are known as joints, and these joints are usually at the elbow, the fingers, knees, ankles, etc. Now there are total four types of joints: ball and socket joint, pivotal joint, hinge joint and fixed joint. We'll see what these joints are. Ball and socket joints. The rounded end of one bone, it fits in the cavity or the hollow space, that is जो खाली जगह होती है ऑफ द अदर बोन. सच अ जॉइंट अलाउज मूवमेंट इन ऑल डायरेक्शन, दैट इज 360 डिग्री मूवमेंट. दिस टाइप ऑफ जॉइंट इज यूजली प्रेजेंट नियर अवर शोल्डर और हिप एक्सेट्रा. नाउ दिस इज द पिक्चर फॉर अ क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. यू कैन सी दैट द फर्स्ट पिक्चर, द अबव राइट हैंड पिक्चर, इट शोज द मूवमेंट ऑफ अवर बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट प्रेजेंट इन द शोल्डर. Whereas the second picture shows the joint of the hip. The ball is present and there is a hollow space in which the bone is fixed and it can move in all directions. Next is the pivotal joint. The joint which is present near our neck, which joins the neck and our head, is known as the pivotal joint. It allows us to move our head forward and backward and also from right to left, but it does not allow our head to rotate 360 degree, that is in all direction, which is the main difference between ball and socket joint and pivotal joint. In a pivotal joint, a cylindrical bone rotates in a ring. For example, given in this picture, you can see that the skull is fixed on the backbone of our body with the help of pivotal joint, and we are able to move it right and left, but we are not able to move it in all directions. Now the next come is the hinge joint. Hinge joint is like the hinges present in the door, as it attaches the door with the cupboard and it allows the movement only back and forth. The same way, the hinge joint allows our body parts to move only back and forth, and these are usually present near the elbows, knees, ankles, etc. As you can see in the picture, in the second picture, the hinge is compared to that of the joint present in the knee. Even if you try, you are not able to move it more forward than it actually can. आप ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा आपके लेग को स्ट्रेट कर सकते हो, बट यू कैन नॉट मूव योर लोअर लेग अप अबव द नी. सो दिस इज वॉट हिंज जॉइंट मीन्स. नाउ द फिक्स्ड जॉइंट्स. देर आर सम जॉइंट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द स्कल बिटवीन अवर हेड, एंड दिस जॉइंट्स आर नोन एज फिक्स्ड जॉइंट्स. इट मीन्स वी कैन नॉट मूव दिस जॉइंट्स इवन इफ वी ट्राई टू. The example for fixed joints will be the upper jaw and the rest of the head. The upper jaw is fixed with the rest of the head in such a way that even if we try, we can only move our lower jaw, but we cannot move our upper jaw as it is fixed with the skull. Have you ever built a volcano for a science project? If yes, you might have used a bottle or a wired structure first of all for the support of the volcano, and then you might have attached the tissues or the POP for the rest of the volcano. So in the same way, our body needs support and shape, and for that particular shape and support there is skeleton present in our body. All the bones in our body form a framework to give shape to our body. and this framework is called the skeleton. Now there are small bones present on the back of our hand. When you feel it, you can feel there are small bones present in our fingers also, with the help of which we are able to bend our fingers. The small bones are known as carpels. Then ribcage. The bones, when you stop your breath, you can touch and feel there are bones present near your chest. And these bones are known as ribs. These ribs, they joined and form a box-like structure. They join with the chest bone and the backbone, and this box is known as the ribcage. There are total 12 ribs present on each side of the chest. And the important parts of our body, like the lungs and the heart, they are protected inside this ribcage. First diagram shows you the only ribcage, and the second shows you how the stomach, the heart, the lungs, they are all stored in the ribcage and they are protected. Then comes the bone. The backbone is made up of many small bones which are known as vertebrae. Total 33 vertebrae are present in the backbone. Just think, if the backbone was made up of one single bone, would we be able to bend? No. Because there are small bones present, we can bend and also we can stand straight or stand erect. So that is because of the backbone. Then next come the shoulder bone and the pelvic bone. When you push the wall, you can feel a structure coming out from the back. That particular structure is known as the shoulder bone. The pelvic bone is present below your stomach, which helps you to sit. Without pelvic bone, it would be difficult for us to sit properly. Next is the skull. The skull is very important, as the important part of our body, that is the brain, is protected and stored inside the skull. And skull is not only one bone. It is made up of many joints and many bones joined together. Next comes the cartilage. Now, cartilage is a material which is not as hard as the bone, but it is not very soft also. So, there are some additional parts of the skeleton that are not as hard as the bone and which can be bent. These are called the cartilages, and it is also found in the joints of the bone. Here is a picture which represents where the cartilage is usually found, which is in our ears. The upper part of the ears is having the cartilage, whereas the lower part of our ear is known as the ear lobe. Other than bone and the cartilages, there is one more thing present in our body which helps us to work. These are known as the muscles. The swollen region in the upper part when you bend your arm, making a fist of your hand, is known as a muscle. Muscle works in pair. When one of them contracts, the bone is pulled in that direction and the other muscle of the pair relax. To move the bone in the opposite direction, the relaxed muscle, that is the second muscle, it contracts and it pulls the bone towards its original position, and the first muscle relaxes. The muscle can pull, it cannot push. Thus, whenever any work is required to be done by muscle, there are always a pair present and not only a single muscle to move the bone. As you can see in this picture, when you are making the fist of your hand and you are bending your arm from your elbow, a swollen region is appeared, and this swollen region is due to the muscles. Again, when you relax your hand, the muscle comes back to its place and it expands. Now we'll study what are the other movements made by the animals and different creatures. First one is the earthworms. Now earthworms, when they move, they first of all extend the front part of their body and they keep the rear portion, that is the back portion, fixed to the ground. Then it fixes the first end of its body and releases the cecum, that is the back portion, and it shortens the body. Again, it pulls the forward part and it sticks the back part of the body. In this way, the earthworm moves. Now, under its body, it has large number of tiny bristles, which is hair-like structures, and these bristles help the earthworms to get a good grip on the ground, and these bristles are connected with their muscles. As you can see in this picture, the earthworms, they are moving in the left direction. First of all, the back portion is fixed and the front portion moves forward. Then the front portion is fixed and the back portion is expanded and move forward, and this continues. There are small hair-like structure you can see at the bottom of the earthworm, and these earthworm, they move with the help of their body and they fix their body on the ground with the help of the bristles. Next animal is the snail. Now we know that snail is the slowest creature on the earth. Nothing can move as slow as the snail. But how does it move? First of all, have you ever seen a snail? If you have, you might notice that there is a small rounded structure present on the body of the snail, and that is known as a shell. Now this is the outer skeleton of the snail. Unlike humans have their skeleton present inside their body, whereas the snails have their skeleton outside their body. And this shell is a single unit and it does not help in moving from place to place, whereas it has to be dragged along. ये जो शेल है वो स्नेल को हेल्प नहीं करता. इनफैक्ट स्नेल को ये जो शेल है वो ड्रैग करके जाना पड़ता है. अ थिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड द हेड ऑफ द स्नेल मे कम आउट ऑफ एन ओपनिंग इन द शेल, एंड दैट थिक स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज द फुट, विच इज मेड अप ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग मसल्स एंड हेल्प्स द स्नेल टू मूव. एज यू कैन सी द शेल, इट ओनली प्रोटेक्ट्स द स्नेल फ्रॉम द outer heat or enemies, and the foot, it helps us the snail to walk. Then comes the cockroaches. So the cockroaches, they walk, they climb, and also they fly in the air, and they have three pair of legs. All of the three pegs, that is the six legs, they help in walking, and there are two pairs of wings which are attached behind their head. And there is a hard outer skeleton present, which is made up of plates, and that plates help the cockroach to move. The next one is the birds. Now birds have very light bones. They have hollow, means andar se thode bahut khali hote hain. They have hollow and they have light bones, which helps the bird to fly. And the hind limbs, that is the backward limbs, they help the bird to walk or perch. Perch means to rest. So when the bird wants to walk or rest, they usually use their hind limbs, whereas the forelimbs are modified, that is used as the wings. And their shoulders are very strong, so when they fly, the muscles present near the shoulder bone, the breast bone, they are also very strong, and they help the bird to move their wings ups and down. Next is the fish. Fish has a body of a streamline. Now what is streamline? That is, the head and the tail of the body is narrow, whereas the middle portion of the body is broad. And it moves in such a way that if the head is moving in the right direction, then its tail will be moving in the left direction, making a curve of the body. The same way, if the head is moving in the left direction, the tail will be moving in the right direction, again making the curve of the body. In this way, it pushes itself forward, making a force in the water, and it helps the fins and the tails help the fish to swim and to balance its body in the water. The last one here are the snakes. Have you ever seen a snake If yes, you might have seen it crawl or slither in a loop position, not in straight line, but it will always move in loop position. Why so? Because this helps the snake to attach its body to the ground and push forward its head. The snake's body curves into many loops. Each loop of the snake gives it a forward push by pressing against the ground. Since its long body makes many loops and each loop gives it a push, the snake moves forward very fast and not in a straight line. So, if it moves in a straight line, it will move very slow. But agar wo loops mein ja raha hai, to it will move very fast. And there is a long backbone present in the snake which helps it to bend and straighten its body. Here we complete the 8th chapter. Thank you, everyone.